Here's the art connection that I had growing up. So, my family was in the bagel business. We made Lender's bagels. And one of the things that we did, one of the things that my dad did when he was promoting this company is, A, go around and make a fool of himself anywhere he can. He was the salesman.
It was the image of the company.
The image of the company was, he was the face of the company. And our image was that we were a family-owned business from a small-ish town, which we were, and that we were personal. So my dad would go around and he would go into the office of the buyer for a supermarket chain, and he'd pitch him on the bagels. And 10 minutes later, my dad is jumping up and down on this guy's desk, and my dad pulls down his pants and he's got underwear on that says, "Buy our bagels" on it, because he'll do whatever he needs to do to make the sale. And part of that sort of family, that neighborhood feeling that we had was in the art style that we had on the bags and in all of the advertisements.
It was made by someone in a family, or you?
It was not. I mean, honorary family member, because we were all very, very tight-knit. So we had a guy named Willie Evans, who was the art guy at Lender's Bagels. And I used to go hang out at the factory at my father's office on a Sunday. My dad would get me out of the house. He'd drag me down to the office. I'd spend a half an hour walking through the factory line, looking at the most unbelievable machines to make bagels. I'd grab a burning hot bagel off the line, stick it in my shirt because it was too hot to hold on to. And then I'd go watch my dad make phone calls for 5 minutes before I got bored. And then I would go hang out with Willie. And Willie had an office, I'm making air quotes, that was essentially a cleared out section of floor in a storeroom in the attic. And I would go weave my way through all the boxes in the storeroom and hang out, watching him drawing cartoon stuff for the ads, learning how to use the waxer. Eventually, he got a photostat machine. Wow, that was like a big moment.
With
And
the crank?
Well, no, it was like a photographic system for shooting black and white high
Oh,
contrast
I
images.
see. Yeah.
And that was like, this was way before computers. I would hang out with him. He taught me how to prepare a desk for inking
Oh,
with
yeah.
a Winsor Newton Series 7 number 2
So the
brush.
same stuff as for comic books, basically. I mean, setting
Exactly.
up for comic books.
And he was doing that kind of thing. He wasn't doing a lot of sequential, but he was doing some sequential art. And he had this really great friendly cartoon style that everyone just loved. He wasn't a great draftsman, and he knew it. Like, he would look at Jack Davis' work and just cry, boy, if I had that guy's chops. But he had this great approachable quality to his work, and part of that is because he came out of poster painting. So when you went to the deli back in the 50s and they had a special on turkey, and there's that painting on the glass that says 50% off turkey, and there's a little guy with rosy cheeks holding up a turkey leg, that's what Willie used to do. He used to do that. He did a lot of work in egg tempera paint. So we'd have big cutout letters and standees that he would make of cartoon
Do you still
characters.
have some of that his stuff?
I have some of it. Every Jew in New Haven, Connecticut has 10 pieces by Willie over the rafters in their garage because he used to make birthday cards for people that were, like life-sized cards, and he'd send them out. So this guy once, on a dare, painted a ceiling in a tuxedo to prove he could do it without getting a drop on himself, and he won.